Yo, what's good, guys? It's a beautiful new day. Today's video is essentially going to consist of me creating a line once again at Woodward East. This time it's going to be a different skate park. Instead of Cloud 9, we're going to be in Lot 8, so let's get straight into it. I kind of already had a general idea of what I wanted the whole line to look like, so I started on the box, kind of getting used to it, checking it out with some backies, fronties, and 360 front rides, kind of getting the feel for it, you know? My initial plan was to do a flip, whip, rewind, rewind, double whip over the box, but I was doing flip whip and just like chasing like a madman, so I switched it to fronty. Working on the line over the box. This will be my first three tricks of my line. I ended up stomping two of them, but I ended up casing like super bad. So I was like, you know what? Forget this, let's go again. Once I got into like the fourth and fifth attempt, I started messing up on my whip, fronty, whip rewind, kickless. And to be honest, that's not too hard of a trick for me. So I knew this was just from fatigue. So I took a rest on that. It's been like 20, 30-ish minutes. Now we're gonna go and move on to the quarter. I'm gonna work on something else right now, so that way I don't kind of have bad muscle memory on that fronty whip rewind kickless. So I was just working on the 9-foot quarter pipe, I think it is. I worked my way up from a buttercup to whip buttercup, and then I landed a whip buttercup bar, and that was second go. It's a bit frightening to do that trick, but at the same time, it's not. It's frightening, one, because you're coming at that quarter with literally as much speed as you could possibly imagine, but I'm comfortable with that trick, so that aspect of it isn't too scary. It's just being so high up, you know, off the ground and doing this trick. I'm glad it's a familiar trick, so I'm gonna try, get back in there, do it two more times so I can get comfortable with it. I'll try to get them back to back. The idea is I'm trying to simulate that fatigue that I'm gonna have when I'm doing all these tricks at once. All right, sweet, so I just stomped three whip buttercup to bars. To be honest, I'm gonna go back in there, get two more. And the reason for that is because my style was like really at an all-time low. When I landed, my knees were compressed and I just wasn't really in control of my speed at that point. For me, when I say style, I think of landing in transition, landing with your knees almost completely straight and already ready to get into the next trick you're about to do. So it's just, the idea is, you're setting yourself up for the next thing that's coming in the line that you're doing. So, with that said, I'm gonna go for the whip buttercup bar again, be a little bit more comfortable with it, and pull out a bit more. I'm happy with those. My style was leveled up definitely on all three of those. I'm gonna move now, hitting this little transfer right here. Check it out. Coming from this, coming down, up this black bank, in the air, landing into that guy. that's the move. Trying heel fingery on double over this gap. That last attempt was good because I landed it, but I landed like at the metal. I'm gonna try to land higher in transition so I have more speed for this. I like that one a lot better. I landed with plenty of speed and I actually went into a whip buttercup over there. I'm quite tired just from like long week. Probably gonna try putting all of this together tomorrow, but I do wanna work out a couple more kinks here and there. That heel fingery on double, it's really just like a filler, because honestly, I could just jump that gap right there with no trick and I could save my energy. But honestly, that attention to detail, I think is what separates you from being good and great, you know? So I'm trying to fill in the gap. Okay, sweet, that's the attention to detail that I'm looking for. Just a quick little downside whip to lip slide. I'm not the best at any type of grind, so incorporating that into a little line is good enough for me. Right now I gotta figure out what the heck I'm doing after the whip buttercup bar, because there's really not that many other places you can go with this park. All right, so new plan. After the whip lip slide, do whip buttercup bar, whip rewind over this little box right here, and then I'm gonna hit this weird quarter and then hit this channel, you can't see it right now, front side, and then we'll figure out the end after that. Sweet, I'm feeling comfortable on the downside quad whip. I tried downside front bri over the channel as well, but to be honest, not really into that trick. So I'll stick with the down quad. And then after that, I'm fairly positive that's the end of my run, about 60 seconds. That's the goal anyway. I'm gonna give it a run through right now to verify the time. Then after that, it's time to send it. Since I'm a bit fatigued, I think I'm gonna put off piecing the line together till tomorrow, so that way I can get a full night's rest and feel renewed in the morning and ride at my highest level. I'm pretty sure most people underestimate how much rest does for you. And to be honest, riding when you're fatigued and like super tired is like the worst idea. I've experienced it when you're just kind of like lazy with like dumb tricks and you end up falling. I was lazy like that when I dislocated and fractured two of my knuckles. So definitely not trying to go down that road again, and I know my body needs rest, like 8 hours of sleep type of rest, so I want to be smart. Now, this whole line's gonna be like a lot harder than I imagined, and to be exact, like 20 seconds harder than I imagined, if that makes sense. I just recorded just me running through the layout of my run, and it came out to 40 seconds. The goal is 60, because that's like standardized competition right there. So I'm gonna add a couple things. After the whip buttercup bar, do whip rewind. Flare down heel, full whip, front flare, then do quad down heel. Sorry, quad down whip. So I'm gonna do one front flare right now, then call it a night because it's like 9 o'clock. Look at how bright it is right now. This is 9 o'clock. That's kind of weird to me. But anyway, it's like 9 o'clock and I need rest. Sweet, so I accomplished what I wanted to today. I kind of got the pieces of my line sorted. I can tell you right now that front flare is gonna be the hardest part of the run because it's right at the end and my legs are already tired, and then I have to go and kick off the ramp so that way I'm not like casing. I might end up switching it, but we're gonna see how we feel tomorrow and go from there. When I land this line, it'll 100% be probably among the top three hardest lines that I've ever put together. Just like that, it's the next day. Let's get in there. I'm just gonna get straight into the line, warm up for a second, and then get this line done. Fun fact, I actually filmed this clip after I did the line. Let's check it out. Sweet, and there you have it. Pretty excited on this line that I created at lot 8. I compromised on quite a few things, starting with the heel finger rewind. I was meant to do an extra whip after that, and then instead of downside whip to lip slide, I only did lip slide. And then after that, I came in, did whip buttercup, and I was supposed to catch it and then do a bar spin. For now, I'm happy with what I did. To be honest, my legs are quite dead. I've been riding pretty hard this week, but that was really good simulation for me and kind of putting together most of my hardest tricks that I can do into one line. Like I said before, this is really just prep for this next competition that I'm gonna be going to. It's the wild card competition for World Finals, hoping to qualify and get to Worlds. Should be a fun time, I'm excited. So anyway, despite the minor compromises, I'm happy with this line and I'm super stoked. I could make a video about it too and bring you guys along. So I'll see you guys in the next one. Deuces.